tell you where your dildo got no end of spot.
Was it actually based out of the gate layout, I think?
No, I don't believe this club's got it to say anything, I honestly don't know. But it's a very nice layout, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, Gary Sanson put it the other day, he was asking about that layout about Deep Cove. Have you seen that one?
Was that at Doncaster?
No.
I think I've read about it in the magazine.
No. This used to be a big place for train spotters.
Which station actually laid out here, then, Pete?
You see when it's... Road bridge down. Yeah. You can imagine that was the end of station ramp. Yeah. That road bridge, since we've got bangers down. Yeah. The bridge was perforated or something, and the steam has stopped underneath. And he's done smoke and that used to melt tarmac on road.
Yeah.
Country to have lock and belt. To have lock and belt.
What's that?
Well, you know when you've got a signal box, tickling to belt and empty and pull the attention of that train for you?
Yeah.
That's your lock and belt.
Oh, so, yeah, right.
It's the first place in the country to have it. You also look at the tunnel now.
The lights.
Look at the tunnel now. So all the tunnel now going to Derby are all posh. When you're coming back, they're all dead plain as you're going towards London.
What extent I don't know, like, what was that company that bought it?
Antrax. ABB, was it? I can remember building 45s now, we're around train spotting.
What, in Derby Works?
See, when we came this morning up the A1, there's an old camera, you know, static camera.
There's not been people sitting over there,
Friday.
See, all the buildings have gone from there, look. That was all the massive Derby Works.